So now that we have our plan in place, now we actually get into the fun stuff, the code, creating our first HTML document. I hope you're excited as I am. So HTML, of course, stands for Hypertext Markup Language, but you never hear people say it that way. It's always just HTML. I guess it just rolls off the tongue. So HTML is the text that is to be displayed on the web page with tags around it that specify how the browser should render them. And they're very semantic in that the words sound a lot like what they mean. So that helps it for us, especially those brand new to programming, never done any programming in their life, because the tags, the code, sounds a lot like what they mean. So with that said, take a deep breath. We're in this together and you're going to learn how to code. So let's start by actually doing our own code. So we always start out with some HTML tags to open and close. So I'm going to actually open up Aptana Studio 3, which is a free text editor. You can also use Notepad++ or one of my favorites, Visual Studio Code, both also free. But Notepad++ and Visual Studio Code are both PC only. Love the PCers out there. I use PC and Mac both. Since I'm on a Mac this time around, we're going to use Aptana Studio 3, which is cross-platform, meaning that it works on both. Best of both worlds. So let's go ahead and open it now. Now, I have a basic document set up for us to just give you an example of what it looks like. So right off the start, very simple. Doc type HTML with an exclamation point in the front. So let's do this together. I'm going to go new, and then I'm going to go to file. So I just want it to be blank. I don't want it to be anything fancy. With Aptana Studio 3, if you select HTML5, for example, it will give you a lot of the code, the framework already done, which is great once you have coded for a while. You don't want to have to do all that busy work. But for those of you that are brand new to this, you definitely want to start from scratch because you want to learn it. So, okay, so now that we have a document open in Aptana Studio 3, let's get started. Let's write our first line of code. So HTML5, the W3C, which is the World Wide Web Consortium, the brainiacs that talk about the standards of web development code, have gone really back to the basics as far as HTML5. We are now level 5. That means there, yes, have been actually 5 predecessors, HTML 1, 2, 3, 4, 4.01, and then XHTML, which was a nice redheaded stepchild that was very complex. And now we're on HTML5, which is the new golden standard. The community has now said that they're not even going to release any more versions, so there's never going to be an HTML6, because 5 is the standard now, and any modifications will now be made on 5. So, woohoo for us. That means we don't have to worry about learning anything crazy different in the future. So with HTML5, it's very simple. We type our first bracket, and with most of these text editor programs, they're pretty smart, and they will give us what they think we're looking for. Since this website has not been started yet, and I'm writing my very first line of code, it knows I need to type the doc type statement. But again, you're starting off, so you want to type this all by hand. Exclamation point, doc type, space, and then HTML. We have to tell it what kind of code we're using. So this statement tells it this document is going to be an HTML document, so we'll render the code accordingly. And then enter. So now that we have our first line of code, what's next, right? Well, what we always start out with, if you think of us in anatomy, we have at the top is our head. So we're going to put in our head next, within the brackets, and it automatically gave my closing bracket. But if you are just using plain old Notepad or something that doesn't have these extra features, make sure you type in this closing tag, which is the brackets with a forward slash in front of the head. And then I'm going to break these open here just by hitting enter. HTML is white space insensitive, which means that you can have as much blank space or as little blank space as you want. The spaces mean nothing. Now when we type, of course, our actual web content, we want to put some space in. But when it comes to this code stuff, spaces really don't matter in between the code. So we're going to leave this like this for now, except for it's very important to have a good structure. And good structure is to have two spaces between each nested element. So this is the mother here at the very top. Then two spaces, we have the head nested. And then within the head, we want to have a title, so that's going to be another two spaces. So for title. And this is that title that shows up on the top of the browser along the top bar. So we'll just say, hello world. Then after the head comes the body. And we want the body to be in line with the head. They are equal, so two spaces. Crack that open again, and we will just say, hello world. But you know what, this is our title, right? This is the top of our site. So we are gonna make this a heading by doing an H1. Now there are up to five different headings, and H1 being the highest of them, the largest, it does mean as far as accessibility as structure goes. If someone was using a screen reader, it would let them know that this is the title of the document, heading one, and so on. So the structure is important. So if I'm using a heading later on down the road in this web page, I probably want to do a heading two, unless it's a whole other topic, then another heading one, and so on. And we'll dive more into that detail later. And now let's close it by doing a closing bracket. By bracket forward slash again, H1. And then now let's actually type some content here. So we're going to do a paragraph, which is just the letter P. Close that paragraph. And then we will say, this is my awesome website. Woot woot. Okay, I didn't type in the woot woot. And once we are done with the body, then we can go ahead and close this. We're going to do something very basic. So by closing our document, we want to make sure to do the bracket forward slash HTML. And that closes this out. So we have our document type HTML. We have our head. Within our head, we have our title. We have our body. And within our body, we have a heading. And oh, we've got a couple spaces there since it's nested. A heading and then a paragraph. And then we closed our body. And we closed our document. So now let's see what this looks like on the web. So in Aptana Studio 3, we're just going to go to run, and I'm going to select to run. It always will require you save changes. If you are wanting to view this on the website and you're not using Aptana, just save the document as helloworld.html. Very important you add that .html. So it knows how to read the document, and then just double click on it on your desktop and it will automatically open up in your default browser. So I'm going to click yes here because once it saves, and voila, it's actually open on a website. If this is out on my computer, because I haven't put it on a web server yet, web server is a whole other topic, but you see the title shows up here at the top, hello world. Here's my heading one, and here's my paragraph, this is my awesome website. And that's it. We have made our first very basic website that only we can see so far until we put it out in space. But that's it, folks. How easy was that? It may take you some practice, but just think how much you can accomplish. Next, we will talk about web servers and how to put your stuff on a web server. And then through the weeks ahead, we'll actually add in more complexities, color, style, navigation, and oh, there's just so much ahead. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and please subscribe. Make sure you get the videos in the upcoming weeks, and I will see you next time.